Hello, Davenport, Toronto. I'm Julie Zeritz, your Member of Parliament, and this is my Monday video for the week of April the 12th. The House of Commons is back in session this week, and there's lots of legislation that is it is planned to come through for a vote. First one to mention is C-14, which is the bill with a lot of measures that were announced in the fall economic statement at the end of November. Including an increase to the Canada Child Benefit, a one-time increase, the rent subsidy, being able to get the rent subsidy dollars in advance before having to pay the rent, and tons of other measures to support businesses and students as well. We also have UNDRIP, so the United Nations Declaration for the Rights of Indigenous Peoples, coming through for second reading. And then we also have C-12, which is the Climate Accountability Act, coming through as well. And interesting to note that Mark Carney gave a speech on Friday night, and he said the following: climate was going nowhere before this government, so the Liberal government, the federal Liberal government, took office. Now we have a legislative target to net zero. Canada's the first country in the G20 with a climate policy serious enough to make a difference. It was really wonderful for him to validate that. He is a special advisor to the United Nations on climate change and a two-time bank governor, both in Canada and the UK. And so his support means a lot. I also want to let Davenport residents know that the Federal Minister of Health and the Federal Minister of Seniors made an announcement to add three new amazing people to the National Seniors Council, including Dr. Samir Sinha, who's the chair of geriatrics at Mount Sinai. We have an unbelievable council, and we are determined at the national level to do everything we can to make sure that our seniors live with dignity and in health for their senior years. I also want to say that I'm really happy that Minister LeBlanc has indicated yesterday on CBC's Rosemary Barton's show that a discussion around a universal basic income is a valuable one to have. And he also said he felt it is a policy that we think deserves a lot of consideration. So we being the federal Liberal team. So wanted to say that that's great news as well. As everyone knows, I've introduced a private member's bill, C-273, which would enable a national framework and a national strategy for guaranteed basic income. So wanted to say that that was additional good news. I'm going to end off on some tough news. There's a huge race, as everyone knows, between the variants and the impact it's having on positive COVID numbers and the race to get vaccines into Canadians across the country. The numbers in Toronto don't look great as of this morning. It is predicted that by the end of April, we're going to have the numbers rise from around 1,000 now to about 2,500, which is really awful. So I know everybody's tired of hearing this, but I want to say this: please, please, please get vaccinated. If you're over 18 and you have the following postal codes in Davenport, M6H, M6E, M6K, or M6N, you will be able to sign up within the next couple of days. Just stay tuned for details on the radio, on TV, on social media of how to sign up and get vaccinated. I'm in one of those hot spots. I will be vaccinated ASAP. If you are over 50 and in a hot spot postal code right now, you could actually sign up right now. So just go and go to the Ontario or City of Toronto vaccination websites, and they'll be able to direct you. If you're over 55, you can get vaccinated at a pharmacy. Again, go to ontario.ca vaccination sign up site to find out more details and locations. And if you're over 60, again, you can sign up at one of the hospitals. So lots of options available. If you need links, just go to my juliezerowitz.ca website, go to my COVID-19 main page, and you'll be able to get all those links. So Davenport, Toronto, please stay safe, be disciplined, and follow public health directives. We are going to get through this the only way we know how, which is together. Have a great week.